I have a small video for you.
So how many people have used Flipkart here? Oh, quite a lot. Okay. How did you find the service? I mean, how many people were satisfied with the service? Yes.
So, I think that was 9 years ago.
Yeah, yeah. Your first question to the audience was, how many of you have heard of Flipkart?
Yeah, not many people had heard of it. I think I remember it was very noisy.
Yeah, yeah.
And also, it was my first time speaking at a public event as well. And I remember the moment when everybody cheered was when I declared very proudly that we are selling one book every minute. And that was a big cheer. Of course, the ambition to become more than just a bookstore was there at the start itself. But I think somewhere around 2010 or 11 is when we realized this could be much bigger. We just knew that we were in like a really big space, it's like almost infinite room to grow in this, and we should just keep going. My advice is that one is you should raise the bar of hiring really high. Right? So do not hire until you are convinced that this person is going to like be really fit for the job that you're planning to do at the scale you're thinking of. So in the even from very, very early days, our bar for hiring was high. You want people to think that they are ultimately not just working for your boss, their boss or somebody. They actually have a part ownership of the company. By mistake, we happened to be in a very, very big space where the vacuum was so strong that we got sucked into that, as then the opportunity was so big. Everything like chicks came very fast at us, right? So you had to learn on the job, you have to try, you have to improvise. Keep thinking of, okay, what's the right thing to do right now, and just keep doing that and learn from your mistakes and move on. So I think that's how I approach things. You, based on whatever data is available at that time, instead of getting into analysis paralysis, doing whiteboard discussions and analysis pros and cons, and you keep doing that, there's no end to that. So one thing that I've learned is that do not try and solve problems. Try and think of opportunities that are in front of you and see how you can go towards them, right? Instead of saying that this is the problem that I'm facing, I want to solve this problem, that doesn't lead to a very good, not the best outcomes. I think logistics, starting a logistics was something that on your own logistics for the first time was actually a pretty big decision. And in fact, I myself was not sure of it. I believe that Flipkart is in a great, very good place. I think it's going to be very successful. I think Amazon is like sounds like a very big threat, like Uber sounds like a very big threat. But I believe that both Flipkart and Ola, for example, in the transportation space, I think these companies will do very, very well in the space. Taxi space doesn't seem like a one-player market. Didi from China coming out and going out to these geographies, or Ola coming out of India and going in these geographies, I think Ola has a better chance than Didi against Uber. It's clear that Chinese companies are largely, the tech companies are still more China-oriented, and take some time for them to become global. The amount of technology transformation that is about to happen in the world, you can't even imagine that. We have seen nothing yet. All this will look like dark ages in 10 years' time. In IIT, I wanted to drop out and become a gamer at that time.
As an entrepreneur, what would you advise to other entrepreneurs, especially when it comes to building big businesses?
The first thing to build a big business is to think big. I think that would be my first advice. Think big and then say, okay, what's the first small step based on my current resource availability I can take to move in that direction? I don't know whether I'll get there or I'll change my direction at some point in time, but essentially I would think, take a big target.